my boys. Welcome to a new video.
Tudo bem? We have been in Douro Valley. We have been in Aveiro.
In Serra da Estrela, in
Nazaré.
Porto, everywhere. And yet, we have more because today we are gonna explore Alentejo.
Our favorite region of Portugal. And it's again with our favorite travel companion,
Ushuel.
And
Sagres Vacations.
Sagres Vacations.
Yes.
So we have 4 days of exploration, and today we're starting out in probably the most Alentejo-ish town you'll ever find.
Arreolos.
See, that's why we have a local guide with us who can correct us and who can teach us things. Hi, Joel.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
Is it your favorite region too, of Portugal?
Yes, it's the food, it's the farming area.
Of course, the food had to be included.
The wine, the cork, the marble.
Very few people come to Alentejo, that's why we love it. And maybe that you should not even film this. We don't want to share how beautiful it is.
Yeah, Alentejo almost has a lower population density than Namibia. Okay.
Yeah. I think there are more black porks here than humans.
But we'll try to change that. Nom, nom, nom.
So we actually have a first stop here at Fabrica Hortense. It's a rock factory that makes traditional rocks that were brought from the Moorish people all the way up to Portugal. And today here in this region you still find stores and factories that manufacture these rocks by hand. And they use the traditional ways, but they have a lot of new designs, but they also have the really classical ones. And we just had a stroll here and I fell in love with a lot of items. I don't understand how this is not something that everybody knows about. I mean, Persian rugs go home. This is so much cooler. And we were so lucky to have a talk with the owner here, who is also the designer. And she actually have made a rug that was offered to the Pope. And he has the rock now.
So this is a rock being made in action, and everything is made by hand. And you're probably wondering, how are they, are they just freestyling or what? But actually they follow a blueprint that they make beforehand. What is interesting about these rocks is that if you take a big rock like this, it takes, like this one takes 6 months to make. Imagine one person spending half a year or an entire year on just one project. O preço?
1900.
If this was in Denmark, it would be 19,000 euros.
But it's so pretty. Even though this store is absolutely gorgeous, this was the first thing my eye caught when I walked in here. Because look at this, it's like a classical design made in a furniture, you know? The rug that we have at home with this one, the baby is mine.
É verdade, vocês estão com medo.
Arreolos.
What is the deal with this town here? You say this is like the picture of an Alentejo town.
This is very picturesque. Because here you can see the traditional Alentejo. You can see the white houses with the colors, the around the doors and around the windows. It is very popular in Alentejo.
Seems like all villages have their own kind of handcraftsmanship that they're good at. So yeah. Here it's all about rocks. Then you can go to somewhere where it's only about cork or wine or whatever.
It's or like marble. Estremus.
Or marble, yeah.
Estremus you have is very well known because of the marble, also because of the wine and cork.
And we're going to Estremus now.
Estremus.
Oh my God, yes. It's going
that
well.
One,
we're going to have lunch on a brand new restaurant.
Are you hungry?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Guys, guys, if you are dying to get a once-in-a-lifetime trip around Portugal, you should consider doing it with our partner Sagres Vacations.
We have been on several trips with Sagres Vacations, and they have given us some of the best experiences we've ever had here in Portugal.
Carinho, saúde, amor!
We have stayed so many beautiful places.
And we have eaten and drunk so much deliciousness that it's even hard to understand.
Look at the cheese!
This might be the best fish I have ever had in my entire life.
So how does it actually work? So this is Joel, he's your private guide and your private driver.
He takes you around in style while telling you insights, history and general knowledge that only the locals know. This gives you a much more rich travel experience as you don't miss what must not be missed.
But what tours does Sagres Vacation offer?
That's completely up to you, because Sagres Vacations, they offer 100% customized and tailored trips to accommodate your hopes and wishes of a Portugal trip.
You simply write an email to our friend Patty, and then she will help you plan a trip that you will never forget.
And the best thing, if you let Patty know that Stay Classy sent you, you'll get 10% off your entire trip.
Let's carry on this adventure.
Wow. Look how many there are. Oh my, would it be irresponsible to put up the drone?
Yeah, I already told you no.
Oh my god, I've never seen anything like this. So as you can understand, here I'm a big bird enthusiast. I think it's eagles, yes, because they are massive. Absolutely. We told Joel, hit the brake. There are a dozen of wild eagles. Usually you only see falcons here, but here you have a pack of gigantic eagles. Oh my god, that's so cool.
You know who you remind me of? The Viking version of that crocodile
of Steve Irwin.
Yeah.
My dad taught me from a very early age.
Oh, look at that. Oh, it's big and beautiful. Oh my god, it's like a goddamn Airbus 320. Oh, it's diving. Oy, 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 oy. I'm just gonna stay here, guys.
Bye.
Bye.
So we just drove to Estremoz, and this area is very, very famous for its wine and for its marble and for its cork. The first thing we are gonna do is to fill our belly with some Alentejo food.
I like the tranquility, that's my favorite thing about Alentejo. But my strong second is the food here. The food is just fantastic here. Father, are you listening? It is fantastic.
Wonderful.
Interpretation of what Alentejo is famous for, and I can, well, you can already guess that the food here is pretty amazing. You know, Alentejo is in many ways known as a forgotten land in a way, but more and more it's becoming an attraction of modern fancy restaurants and even hotels. We've stayed at the Land Vineyard in Montemor. And this is a beautiful contrast to the more raw and authentic side of Alentejo, which we will see much more of, by the way. Mm-hmm. But I think this is, the food is A-class. When you look at the drone footage, it's pretty incredible to see just how big of a deal the marble is here. Like, they are digging hundreds of meters down into the ground. for this material, and eventually it ends up at a beautiful bathroom or kitchen. Anyway, if you're coming to Estremoz, there is another restaurant. And I know if I don't say this, our friend Antonio...
Fuck this shit, I'm never doing a video.
He will kill me, because usually you go for the typical Alentejo food, and the restaurant is called Venda Azul. Did you know that Alentejo and Portugal is known for its cork production? This is where half of all the cork production in the entire world is made. And right now we are at a cork factory where we are getting taken through the whole process of how we get to enjoy wine that doesn't leak. And this is a boiled cork, and this is the cork that is cut off the trees. Looks the same, but it's different.
So the difference is that the one that you looked at for before is the one that was just harvested from a tree like this. And this one is after the factory have had their fingers on it and have been boiling it in water so that it's more flexible and has no bacteria in it. But what we never think about when we drink like a wine and we look at the cork pulp, we smell it, but we never really realize that it comes from the skin of a tree like this. And what we don't know is that it takes so many years from when the farmer puts the seed in the soil to it goes to your bottle, because a tree like this takes 25 years to give cork for the first time. But it doesn't even give you the right quality of cork that you can use for the bottles. You have to wait 2 times 9 years,
yeah,
for harvesting.
43 years from planting the seed until you have a cork tree that is actually usable. So every time you open a bottle of wine and you have a little cork in it, it's been at least 43 years in the making. So cork is not just cork, there are different levels of quality. And here in the bottom, we have the bottom quality. And this is cork that is skipped a harvesting year. So it's 18 years old. And you can see this by the oxidation. And then when you go up to the top here, you can see how compact it is. And this is the highest quality of cork. And when you look at a cork tree, and the value you get out of a cork tree, it can vary from as little as 15 euros for an entire tree to 225 euros for a good tree. So it all depends on the DNA and the health of the tree, and if it's pointed towards the right direction.
I have never known that this is how a champagne bottle screw prop thing is looking like. Apparently they compress the first part here with cork in smaller pieces, and then in the button they put two of these to make sure that the pressure is kept so that there's no air being let out. So they don't look like a mushroom when they put them in the bottle.
The bottom one is pure cork.
These ones, yeah.
And then the top is a cheap one. You know, my amazing father,
wonderful,
he told me that the reason why you see more and more bottles with a screw cap is because there is a shortage of cork. I just asked, is there a shortage of cork? No, there's not. Myth busted. I mean, let's look at the products here, because it's amazing what you can do with cork.
I call one.
Man, we need
is that for ice?
No, this is for it's a champagne cooler.
Oh, I thought it was for ice.
We need this on the balcony. This is for your hot pans. This can be on your bathroom. Serve some gin and tonic.
Joen.
So this is actually waterproof. A fun fact is that, you know, when you walk around Lisbon, you see a lot of these souvenir shops that sell cork products. The truth is, many of these shops, they don't sell the real deal. They say fake plastic from China. if you can smell something when you're in the shop, if the cork smells of anything other than nothing, it's fake. Also, if it's too cheap, it's also fake.
Let's go to Évora.
Down below, I thought you wonder at a level. I don't need much in my life, I know. I like you better underwater. I've been drowning in the memory.
Guys, we kind of left you guys hanging a little bit because we actually drove to our hotel and we watched a beautiful sunset. The hotel is Victoria Stone Hotel and it's located
Victoria,
and it's located in Évora.
Do you have a few words just to attach to Évora? Because you know we gotten a lot of comments from people saying you gotta come here.
Well, first of all, Évora is the main city in Alentejo region. It's a walled city and it's a UNESCO site. Tomorrow I'm going to tell you all about the Évora city, but for now it was a city that that was conquered by the Moors, from the Moors, in 1166 by a guy named Giraldo.
I feel a little bit insecure about the fact that we haven't had any classical Alentejo food today. So and also I said in the beginning of this video that we were making an effort to reduce the population of black pigs. And I am doing a massive effort because I have at least the leg of a black pork, right? A black pig right here. Migas and porco preto is basically the picture of Alentejo. Why do you think Alentejo is the best region in Portugal?
I'm not saying it is the best. Okay, so that's the one that I like most. I love their food, I love their wine, I like the people, I like the history. Well, I think it's a very nice region, it's very calm and quiet. Mm. You can have...
Unlike you?
Yes.
I'm the one eating the entire dessert now. It's
You're
so good.
You're acting as if it's something new.
It is, you will be honest.
I didn't touch it.
Amalie, no wonder people ask if you're pregnant.
I was trying to make a joke here. Now you guys are teasing me. How did this happen? Okay. Yeah.
No more chit chat.
We are tired.
No more chit chat.
So the point is, obrigado por ver o vídeo.
Yeah.
Até logo.
Até amanhã, João.
Até amanhã.
Quando visitamos o Évora.
Évora.
O Évora.
I like today. And tomorrow it continues.
See you in the next video.